let's talk about when health monitoring is required and what the process looks like. Employers are required to provide health monitoring if an employee's exposure to respirable crystalline silica is reasonably likely to have adverse effects on their health. This may include where employees are regularly inhaling levels of crystalline silica likely to be above the exposure standard, even if employees are using lower order controls, such as respiratory protective equipment, to control their exposure. Silica-related illnesses can be caused by short exposures at high concentrations or by the cumulative effects of lower level of exposures over an extended period of time. Health monitoring is important as it provides information that enables action to be taken to protect any affected worker's health. If it's required, employers must organise and pay for health monitoring. For labour hire workers, the host employer and the labour hire employer must consult with each other to work out who will organise and pay for health monitoring. Health monitoring must be conducted under a medical practitioner's supervision. It can involve a medical questionnaire, a spirometry test, a chest X-ray, or a CT scan, depending on the type and level of exposure. The medical practitioner will provide the employer with an interpretation of the results and any findings of adverse health effects. The results must be given to the worker as soon as possible. WorkSafe has a template employers can use. If the report identifies any adverse health effects, the employer must review the current controls in place to make sure that they are effective and if any further controls may be required. When reviewing controls, health and safety representatives or employees need to be consulted. If the report recommends that an employee should not be exposed to respirable crystalline silica for a period of time, then the employer should follow those recommendations. For example, the employee may have to be assigned to alternative work or another location where exposure to the substance will not occur. This must be done after consulting with the employee and the medical practitioner. The report must also be sent to WorkSafe Victoria. For more information on health monitoring, visit the WorkSafe website.